So we'll do a couple of quick calculations of a Gini index or coefficient. I said sometimes it's called the Gini coefficient if we write it as a number between 0 and 1, and it's written as the index if we write it as a number between 0 and 100. One is the basically decimal form of a percent, the other is the regular form of a percent, right? Because it's a percent of area. So first thing we want to do is we want to recall what the formula for the Gini index is. And the formula for the Gini index is, or Gini coefficient, whichever you prefer to call it, remember, is 1 minus 2 times the integral from 0 to 1 of the Lorenz curve. And the Lorenz curve represents the distribution of wealth in a population. So let's say, for example, the Lorenz curve for a population is given by L of x equals x squared, where x is between 0 and 1. And remember, the input is the percent of the population. So we're going to use our decimal form of a percent here, because we go from 0% of the population to all of the population, or 100%, or 1.0 in decimal format. And so we're going to answer a few questions. First one is, what percent of income is held by 60% of the population? And we're going to go ahead and assume that they mean the lower 60% of the population. So basically, we want to calculate L of 0.6. So L of 0.6 squared, 0.6 squared is 0.36. And so this means 36% of the income is held by 60% of the population. Part B is calculate the Gini index. Okay, so Gini is 1 minus 2 times the integral from 0 to 1 of the Lorenz curve, and this Lorenz curve is x squared. So I'm going to go off to the side here and calculate my integral from 0 to 1 of x squared. So that's 1/3 x cubed, calculated from 0 to 1. We plug in 1, we get 1/3. We plug in 0, we get 0, so that's 1/3. So I go back over here and I plug this into 1 minus 2 times 1/3. So 1 minus 2/3 is 1/3, which is 0.3333 repeating. And so if we multiply this by 100 to get our Gini index, then this is 33.33 as our Gini index. Okay. If we wanted to write as a Gini coefficient, we would just use the 0.33 or 0.333, however many we were asked to round to. Our second example is the income distribution of a population is given by L of x equals x to the 3.5. And again, x represents the percent of the population, and L, the output, gives us what percent of that population, or what percent of the income that population represents. And so again, we're going to ask how much of the population's income is held by 60% of the population. And again, we're going to go ahead and assume that we mean the lowest 60%. You could calculate others by finding, like, If you wanted the top 60%, you would have to take, you'd find L of 1, which would be 1, and then subtract off the lower 40%. So you could do that, but we're just going to assume it's the lowest 60%. So L of 0.6 is 0.6 raised to the 3.5 power. So this one we have to pull out a calculator for. And when we do that, we get 0.6 raised to the 3. Oops, I've got to redo that calculation. 0.6, not 0.06, raised to the 3.5, which is 0.167313. And so that means when we multiply by 100, this is 16.73% of the wealth. So that's 60% of the population only holds 16.73% of the income. Wow, that's not very much held by 60%. Okay, so now let's calculate the Gini index. And remember, that's 1 minus, oops, a little mistake there. 1 minus, there is a 2, but it's not yet. 1 minus 2 times the integral from 0 to 1 of our Lorenz curve, which is x to the 3.5. So off to the side. Again, I'm going to calculate this up. And so when you integrate, 3.5 plus 1 is 4.5, divided by 4.5, and we go from 0 to 1. So when I calculate this up, when I plug in 1, basically we get the answer 1 divided by 4.5. So 1 divided by 4.5 is 0.2222 repeating, which is, in other words, 2/9, right? And when I plug in 0, I get 0. So this is 1 minus 2 times 2/9, or 1 minus 4/9. And so the Gini index is 5/9. So that's well over 50%. So if we multiply that by 100 to get our Gini index, our number between 0 and 100, that would be 0.55 repeating. So that would be 55.55 would be our Gini index. So that's a pretty large Gini index. So there's just a few quick examples, and that's how it's kind of calculated up.